Hey guys, John here, and welcome back to The Present. Today we have a special guest, no, which is si Patrick. So
hello,
Patrick,
hello,
thank
hello,
you so
hello.
Much for being part of our show. Just for you guys, for your information, si Patrick actually is one of the entrepreneurs here in Davao City. But siya na mas gwapo kung gikan sa iyahan, no, ang iyahang background information. Okay, so Pat, welcome again sa show. Kanang sabi tawag ni kanang is there anything, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, unsay mo ang nagihan, unsay mo ang businesses karon para na may idea.
Sige, so ako karon at na ako ay restaurant dili sa Davao, duha ka book, Fat Cow and Asian Cow. So duha na sila ka restaurant na lahi-lahi og concept. Ang isa serving modern na bistro food, karang mga steak, mga pasta, salads, and the other one, which is kung asa taron, Asian Cow, is kanabang mga modern Asian interpretation nato. So I'm also a chef sa atong mga restaurant. So galuto jud ko dire, and all the recipes and all the, I mean all the grind here, ako jud nagsugod, which is money, one of the struggles which you mentioned kay kalang lisod mag-start up, no? Lisod mag-start up samot na kalang we're in line sa karabang negosyo na we offer service, tas napatay pagkaon, then we have to take care of our people, which is kana may naga-front line para sa tua. Muna, sa karon
Motundua.
Yeah.
So, naki Fat Cow, that's the modern bistro niya na restaurant. Mm. Tapos na po siya Asian Cow, no? So parehas lang duha cow. Pero na po kay isa ka murag na po kay mga content, 'di ba? Online like Chef Patrick ko.
Yes, natay katong atong ginahimo na cooking show.
Cooking show.
No, cooking show na panagsa the latest we did is the katong 7-Eleven. Mm-hmm. So nagpalit tag mga kanang mga ready to eat food sa 7-Eleven. Tas giluto na to sa atong kusina. That's what we're trying to, ano ba, among gusto ipasabot na masking pag 7-Eleven na pagkaon, pwede na to sa i-level up sa atong sariling balay. No? So, check out our mga cooking shows na to na sa Chef Patrick ko on Facebook o sa Instagram. O baka di ay namoy matunan ba ng mga tips and tricks sa pagluto. Kaya you don't actually need to be a chef, no, para makakabalo ka maluto. Pwede ra ka mag-research, tapos practice. Sipiatrug ka, pero okay ra. Diba? Yeah.
Ako la personally, di ko kabalo magluto, guys, just for your information. But si Patrick is really into cooking. No? That's the reason why he has two restaurants. If you don't mind, pila ka years na ba ning mga restaurants niyo?
Okay, so ang Fat Cow, nanata sa upat ka tuig for years. Then, Asian Cow is coming 2 years. No? So, mapansin ninyo, kaning mga restaurants ni Dugul ra. It's like less than 500 meters away from each other. The reason being, at first, dagkan kay mangutana na, ano, giduol man nimo, baka ang customer nimo maghati ba? But for me, depende mangod siya kung say outcome yung mong gusto, kung say mong ginaplano na outcome, no? Sa kuha mangod, kay since ako hands-on ko na chef and restaurateur at the same time, mas gusto na ako na kanabang maadtuan ako everyday. So, pag mukhaan mo dere sa Fat Cow man sa Asian Cow, most probably you're gonna see me every day. Kinaadjud ko dere samot na pagkalang operation hours, which is our lunch and dinner, no? So, mukhaan mo dere, pangitaan lang ko. Tapos ako'y magluto para ninyo. Pwede ba to?
Pwede siguro.
Antod sa makaya.
Antod sa makaya.
So, kana, atong mga restaurant is very near to each other. And kung sa ano po sa business, ano po sa business, business end po, for me ang akong approach manggod is mas dali siya i-manage kay tungod duol siya. So kung ako'y problema na kailangan ba i-troubleshoot, tabok lang ko. Kung baktason, pwede ra baktason, di ba? And for other people, ang opinion nila ana is murag ka lang gina oversaturate ba nako ang term mo ba,
no,
ang market. Pero for me, lahi-lahi magpagkaon ang menu diri ug menu dito, di magkapareho. So ano mo ba problema? I mean, that's my personal opinion, and that's how I, di ba, that's how I work.
Mo lang giningon na to, guys, na when it comes to business, lahi-lahi tag mga diskarte. So that's the mo na diskarte ni Patrick. And actually sa inyo hapod, naamoy mga ideas na yung uban sa inyo nangutan about having a restaurant or like starting a restaurant kung sabay kailangan ng mga, you know, things to prepare for, right? By the way, kung 4 years na, how old ba ka ato katong nagsugod ang Fat Cow?
Nagsugod ang Fat Cow, bali, it took us around siguro 4 or 5 months to construct the restaurant. So back then, I was 18, but when we, oh, sorry, 19.
Wow.
Pag open ako, 20 anyos ko. That was last April, no? April-ish. So, muna, medyo lisod yun siya for the first 2 years kay karabang literal na hantod karon na naadyo ko diri, and I'm the one who's like hiring people, buying, going to the grocery, going to the market, public markets, and buying my ingredients. I mean, that's how we really started, and up to this day, maupo na mong ginabuhat. Although, syempre, sa negosyo, we need to improve and we need to put systems ba para at least mapasayo na tong kinabuhi gamay, o at the same time maka-venture ta to other ano, to other projects, no, na di kay ta focus sa isa ba. So we have to build our people, mo na importante atong i-train natong tao, i-train na to atong mga tao na how to be good and how to perform, kumbaga how we want them ba. And that requires a lot of time and effort, no? So if you find the right people, they're gonna carry your business. Yeah. Diba?
20 anyos pa ka to, bay?
20.
So currently 4 years na, so 24
na ko.
Wow.
24, wow. Yeah.
Okay, so sa ato pa bay, like when it comes to being a chef or like having a restaurant, it has always been a dream of yours to have one?
Okay, kala bang sugod ko sa, syempre, di ba ginaingon nila na the first few steps we do and the first learnings are at home. Mm-hmm. Inga na man pug ko. Kumbaga, ang mga first steps na ko in this industry, in this, I mean, the hobby pa lang of cooking was at home. Di ba? Watching the television, kala bang makakita kag mag-cooking show, and it's so fascinating to look at, pero kala bang ang curiosity kay ngano sayon na kay buhaton sa ilaha ta sa ato gani mura masunog man tanan, no? So
pagod.
Pagod jud. So ako jud kumbaga experience ba, this job is the, this profession or this hobby if you may call, is all about kumbaga constant learning ra jud ka ba. No, ang pagluto, it doesn't, you don't go to a class then after you're already good, di na siya ingana. Ako ajud, it's murabag, we need to learn it by heart. Practice jud ka, and you're gonna waste a couple of bucks, and di ba, you're gonna waste a couple of ingredients and time, effort na makita ni mong end product kay murag di man jud ni mao sa TV ba, pero try again then di ba, so, makatuon ra ka
sa ato pa murag. It has been a hobby that eventually nahimo siyang business, murag siyang Fat Cow at kaya, age of 20.
Kaya syempre kalabang mag sikagluto, then as a kid you would imagine na lamia po siguro na kalamurag na kay kananan, like what you see on television or in the internet, di ba, na murag these people running their restaurants, murag lami kita na awon ba, and you dream about that, tapos maghopo ka na unta puho na kay nga na. So mauto nag ano ko na venture ko into this after I finished high school. Tapos sa college ko, pero gikapoy ko og eskwela, kay maybe for me education, or I'm being trapped in a classroom ba, nakara bang dili ko interesado go na subject, kay it like pains me ba, murag feel ako dili ko productive mo na, I don't pay attention. So I dropped out, then I got a job in the hotel business, kay gusto mo ko maluto, and that's the only way I could learn, diba? Back then I was 17, so nag-OJT ko. OJT. Tapos finally, I went into culinary school for a year. After ato, nagtrabaho na po ko. Asa ka lang regular na empleyado, kaya I was 19 back then. 18, 19. So, makatrabaho na yung kaligali ba. Then, I work in a hotel, tapos restaurant. Then after, I feel like murag ka lang, I wanted to open my own ba. But honestly, I imagine it na grabe ka sayon ra. Pero sayon na dyan siya kung naon-naon. Pero dili siya sayon buhaton. And you have to like, looking now, ma-realize na ko na murag, I had to give up on a lot of things.
Okay.
Tungod kay nagsugod ko aning negosyo, even though it's a hobby, diba, they say na when you love what you do, murag dili siya hago. Mm. At some point, tinuod, pero hago gyapon, no? Kaya, wala may trabaho, or negosyo, or any profession na simple, diba? It may look simple, but kung ikaw nakadiha sa operation, nakadiha sa opisina, at some point, makaingon dyan ka, lisod ng trabaho. Kung wala ka ng lisod, pasabot, dili na siguro trabaho ba? That's for me, yeah, diba? So,
makes sense.
Going back to, I mean, a lot of things na give up ba? That I give up, like, less time spent with the family because, I mean, I live in the same house with my mom and dad, ug mga igsoo na ako, di ba? Pero, maabot ko doon isa kasimana na di may magkita ay. Kay tungod, ako, I leave, they leave work at around 7:38, tas ako, I leave work at 9. So, when I wake up, kung mahawa ko, wa na sila. Kung muli ipog ko, late man, kay mahuman ang restaurant, 10, maglimpyo pa, mag-prep pa and everything, tulog for the next sila. Day, tulog na sila. So, muabot dun sa time na, nandiyo isa kasi mana dun, na kalang, di dun mo makita ba? Which is so ironic, isa ra mo kabalay. Diba? But, yeah, so that's number one, you had to give up your family. And, for me, number two, you had to give up relationships with friends, and, I mean, your, kumbaga, kalamanga, barkada, ana ba? No? Because it's not like every Saturday night or every Friday night, pwede ka. Mm. Laag ka, mga angkas gawas or manginom or anything, di ba? Murag, di na siya pareha dati before it started. So, that's one of the things that I had to give up, no? Mm. And somewhere along the road of business, dapat yun mo ma-accept na you have to let go of things, you have to grow up, and you have to, kumbaga, if you need to burn bridges, you need to burn bridges. Because at the end of the day, it's kumbaga, once you get into negosyo, survival of the fittest, bina. Diba? Kumbaga, kung di ka maling kamot, daug-daugan dyan ka. Kung tamak-tamakan dyan ka. So you really have to know how to stand up on your own. Hita kag imong diskarte. So, kablog ka paon sa manukad, di ba? Na how would you maneuver your business, your venture, di ba?
So those are the things na imong gi-sacrifice. The quality time with your family members, definitely. Maski na lang puyo sa isa kabalay, but, you know, dili lang dyan magtugma yung schedule. Tapos, you also have to sacrifice the time with your friends or leisure time.
Oh, leisure time, yeah.
Sa ato pa ba, katong when you were still 20, you were willing to give up those things or murag you just learned it along the way?
Actually, what would you expect na it would be this hard? As I mentioned ganiya, sa yun ra kay siya imagine. Pero pag naana diha, makayong ka na, hala, daghana, di problema, no? Murag kapuya di ani, no? Pero you're there and you signed up for it. So, it's either you give up or magpadayon ka. And maybe giving up on a business is not an option, di ba? For a starter. Kaya syempre, gusto good ka, mo-succeed ka. So, kung tagaan ka og mga inganang problema, you have to find solutions for it. And ako, mutuuman dyan ko ka lang. Ingon nila na you learn by experience ba?
Yeah.
Kaya ako, I'm not like professionally trained or I didn't have a bachelor's degree. Nakalabang mo ingon sa kuan na money mo experience, money mo buhaton, aron masulban ni. Kung may nga na. To a certain extent, there are some business topics that pag-abot sa operation, murag wa ganun kung kabalo na modern na siya ang pasabot saan. Ingani, ingana, ng mga terms, di ba? So, I had to learn it by experience and sometimes actually pretend to know. Yeah. Para lang mo makaget kang information from other people na pwede ni mo tunan. Di ba? And syempre, starting out as a very young na chef and restaurateur, medyo lisod siya kay people think that you're just playing around. No, kalangulay mo seryoso sa imo ha.
Because feel of your age.
Age. Muna, para sa kuha, murag learning curve or learning thought, dili ka pwede mo agad sa edad kung how you respect people. Diba? Kay, kumbaga, di man buot pasabot 50, high respect. Kung 20, no respect. Di man pwede nga na. Dapat, Jude, you look at someone, kung what's their personality, how they move, what's their character, kung what they do, and that's how you base your respect. But bottom line, dapat wala, Jude, ano, module ako na learn na murag, lisuda di mo ko respeto sa tao no, knowing that you're in a business that you really put your heart into it pero di ka seryosohon. So how do you break that barrier?
Yeah.
By doing the daily grind, doing wala may sayon jud. It's not like overnight you become a millionaire.
Yeah.
O di man pud na overnight na imo negosyo kay boom lang kalit. Wala may ngana tanan jud iagi og trabaho, iagi og oras, iagi og adlaw, semana, luha, dugo, tanan. Hago jud. And kung sa mga negosyante mo rag normal man na mag-breakdown ka na kay mga kumbaga
depressing moments.
Oh, murag ka mga times good na feel nimo na kapoy na although it's doing good. Kapoy gyapon nga ni ngana, di ba? Mo na pag ang tao gani mo ingon na murag ah, yahaya nimo eh kina kay negosyo, di jud kahayahay dong. Di jud dayahay, di jud dayahay. So pag naga ni mo yung amigo gani na nay negosyo, ay mo magpalibre ha. O ay mo ingon na hayahay sila. Kaya baka makita ra ninyo na murag they're living their life, nagwapo kay porma, tapos di ba? Kaon-kaon lang diri dito, pero you don't know unsa ilang giagihan.
Yeah. Exactly.
And di ba, ang di man nimo ma-gauge din ang tao na nalisod na wala. Napoy lain, di ba? Nakalang tanaw nimo doing good, pero nang lisod din on the back end. Napoy lain, na simple lang kayo, abi niyo not doing good, pero perting big time ma di ay. Di ba? So we have to baga, let's not judge ba?
Yeah.
No? Wala d'yo hayahay. So, guys, when you're getting into business, ay d'yo mong expect kung sayon. Dili na siya si Bill Gates na one day. Miskin si Bill Gates kanya, di kanya one day lang.
Yeah.
Steve Jobs, eh, mapun one day lang. So, kita, di ita ka-expect na one day lang po kuyaw na ta. Diba? We really have to invest na not only money. We have to invest our time. We have to invest our efforts. And you need to invest yourself as a whole na gusto ka ang outcome sa imong negosyo is what you expect. Diba? Kaya ikaw may mo drive ano imong negosyo. Di man lain tao. Yes, you can hire people. You can hire consultants. But end of the day, kung ikaw man ang gusto, imuhang concept, imuhang business model, ikaw mo ano? Ikaw mo direct.
Ikaw mo direct.
Oh, diba? Kumbaga ikaw kapitan. No?
Paabot po sa Philippines, sad to say, no, natin, namagutay kultura, natama itong gingon ni Patrick na feeling mag-una ito, pag na-negosyo itong amigo, marag, uy, okay na ka siya, dato na siya, wala siya problema sa kinabuhi. But actually, that's the total opposite. They go through a lot, okay? So, same wapot, Pat, since you are in the restaurant business, and na po kay friends, especially when you were starting out, naaba ka ng mga toxic traits na nag-expect sila pag-sul sa restaurant na discount or librihon
nila. No, dude.
Inaansan yung pag-handle na.
Anila na siya ka-simple. Para na ako manggod, kung amigo ni mo tinood, o ka lang, they really want to support you, sa way pagduha-duha, mukaon lang na, mupalit lang na kung siya mong ibaligya, and they would be thankful for you. Pero kung makatiming gani ka, o ka ng mga tao na tungod lang negosyo ka, na amigo na ni mo, tungod lang kay na-negosyo ka, na amigo na pumusab, then maybe you should check your friends list ba. Murag di dyan na amigo. So how do I handle that? Ako, professional ang job ko. Pag na-imo approach ako, na-ingana, na murag na-discount, kay amigo na ako si ingana, akong imong amahan, imong inahan, ingani, ingani. Guys, ano yun na kasimple? I hope you get our point na kami, we're also doing business to earn, which is may gusto na tos negosyo. So ako rin ang ginapasabot na as much as I want to, pero if we sacrifice the livelihood of our business, dili pwede. Kaya at the end of the day, di man ta pwede sige libre, libre, libre na lang, discount, discount, tas wala na tayo ginansya. So nga na ta ng negosyo? Kaya nga na, nagtukod na lang tag-charity.
Na
diba? So, dapat jud, kana bang ano lang ba pasabton lang nato na profession in a professional way na di good masakitan ang atong amigo na amigo man o amigo sa atong ginikanan or whatever na ingani mong guna sabay di ba na I hope you respect ba na syempre maski pag mabaligya tag let's say pinaka simpleng rice lang plain rice 20 pesos tinuod ang isa ka kilo 30. Ang one cup pilara na pero ano bugas na dito ng gibayaran na bayad pa tag gasolina pampalit og bugas tubig panglungag gasol pa LPG, tas napatay tao para maglungag, palit patag kaldero. Pero kana, dili na na ma, ano ba, dili na na siya ma-isip sa karaniwan na na tao. Because it's not like, sila kabalot. Tadyang, wapot sila kay, alam-alam ba na, it goes, at there's a lot of things going on just to produce something. Same goes to like, merchandise, tanan. Siguro, man siguro ika lang bangko na nabuhat lag iyaha na way tao involved. Na dyan ay cost na kailangan ka mo palit o plastic, himong bangko, kailangan ni mo o tao para mo hulmag bangko. Iyan na ba? So, it's always, kumbaga sa business, ang tawag na mo ana is expenses ba? No? Expenses. And, at the end of the day, expenses from the word itself, kailangan nato na bayaran.
Yeah.
Diba? Di man ta pwede ginansya, watay bayad-bayad. So, pasabot, illegal na.
Yeah.
Diba? A healthy business for me is you get to earn and you also get to pay your dues. Diba? Di man ta, kumbaga, pag mag-start out ta, syempre, like me, mag-start out kung fat ka, wak man kuy kwarta.
So, giyong sa nimo pag-start?
Oh. So, syempre, I'm also blessed that I have a parent na supportive. So, pag-open ako, sige, okay, ikaw may panganay, sige, o, tagaan na kagingan ni, pero hantod diya lang.
Okay.
Tapos, pagtanaw na ako, marag, di man, dyan, ni tama na kwarta pang abrikan anan ba, this is not what I imagine, pero, kay mo may gihatag, asa pa makumumunit, di ba? And for a 20-year-old, wapag ko ka-experience ng trabaho na dakot ng sweldo. So, you have to deal with it. Kung sa resources na available sa imuha. So, we started there. Tapos, hinahinay. We grew. Then, pag na-extra kwarta, ah, sige, paliktag bagong, ano, lutuanan, o bagong kutsara tinidor. Hantod sa mugwapo. Katong mga customers na nagsugod yun o support sa tua from the first year mark ba? Tas kalang kaon yapon hantod karon, makita dyan nila ang difference sa murag. Hala, nalanggi bagong ingani, ingana.
They're part of the growth.
They're part of the growth ba? And that's so fulfilling for me to see ba na maskin pagkatong sugod pa lang ta na bakikaw pa kayo lihok, hantod sa kalang medyo nag okay. We gain a little respect, nahagyapon sila. Diba? So, another side of that is we have to value our clients, no? Muna yung number one dun sa negosyo para sa ako, ah. Kaya nga, no? Simple lang yan siya. Ang atong kliyente, muna yung muhatag og sales sa tua. Then our sales would maintain our business. And at the end of the day, what do we want? We want our business to last. We want our business to, kumbaga, earn ba? No? So, balik ta sa, ano, kumbaga, you always have to think, ba, asa man manggikan? Maski unsa negosyo, na i-customer. So, we always have to take care of our customer and clients. Maski pag regardless, kung namaligya lang kag cupcake, o nakay kananan, o namaligya kag t-shirt, o namaligya kag sticker, yung na, pinaka-simple. We still have to take care of our business. Akong tawagan na sila business partners. No? Dili na to sila, dili ko sila matawag na customer. Partners, kay nga no, partner na to sila para mo dako. Partner po na to sila para mo last. Diba? Para atong negosyo, hapsay, o kalang natay, return all the time na mga kliyente.
Yeah.
No?
Eh, kanipod Pat, like since ikaw, you have been an entrepreneur for 4 years and then nag-grow ka from one business, from a improving business, kind of expand upon ka, and I think you have also plans to improve, to expand upon. Mm. Kani po lang isa ka dilemma, Manggod, especially if you're a startup entrepreneur, like a bago pa lang ka ba? Kanang, what if daw na kay negosyo, unsa may nindot, unsa may gwapong discarte in your own experience, sweldado ba ka sa imong sariling negosyo or ang ginansya ba sa negosyo automatic padulong sa imuha? How
ako,
sa style?
Kanang, gwapo na siya na pangutana, no? Kay para, for me, Manggod, I do the approach na maskin pag ako ang tag-iya, sweldado ko.
Okay.
Kaya nga no, if sweldado ka, your income personally is consistent. So, pananglitan, imong negosyo ga-earn og, let's say, 500,000 every month. Okay? Let's say lang. Tapos, you're willing to give yourself 10,000 every month. Sweldo ni mo na siya. Mm-hmm. Okay? Katong 10,000, expenses to sa 500,000 na ginan siya. Tama? Mm-hmm. And monthly, maskin pag mabagsak mo sa ka-imong sales, kwauni mo, 10,000 lang dyan. Ngano siya healthy? If you do the other way around, manggod. Pag negosyo ni mo, 500,000 ginan siya. Ah, sige, okay ko, 10,000. Karon kumusaka nag 1 million, tingala gid 10,000 gyapon imong kwaon. Syempre mo expect ka na murag mas dako. And that for me is losing control. If you lose control of yourself, kung pila ang kwarta imong ginakuha sa negosyo, there's a possibility, I'm not saying na mag-down ka, there's a possibility you're gonna overspend. Okay? So, ako jud, kung ako makatambag ko, tagaan ni mong limit imong sarili. Na, pila lang mo kailangan i-spend kada adlaw, pila lang mo gina-spend per month. You re-evaluate ba, dili kay dasmag lang ka. Pagtanaw ni mo, na akay palito na worth 20,000, pero imong sweldo, 10,000. Makaisip man ka, anak, na murag sus, pag-iya mo kong negosyo, paliton ko na. Ginansan ako, 500,000.
So, sahay pa yun, di business expense, paski na personal expense.
Oh. Tapos di man siya part sa negosyo. Huwag ka nang ginansya, tinuot, imuha na siya. Imuha nang hinaguan. But at the end of the day, that's a business. Diba? Di man ka pwede bunlot-bunlot lang diha. Kaya nga no, kailangan mata mo maintain ng kwarta pang roll. Mao na itong ginatawag na, ang sana?
Rolling.
I'm sure nakadungog na mo na, rolling. Huwag isa po, pag sugo din mong negosyo, di ko mo tuo na wala kay investment na na bawion. Naadyo kay bawion na. So, mo na ginatawag na to ROI, di ba? Return of investment. Kung sige kang kuha, mas dugay mong ROI. Tinuod di mo negosyo, gwapo. Tinuod di mo negosyo, dagag tao. Pero, at the end of the day, pagtanaw ni mo si mong libro, si mong mga file, huwag mong gugaginan siya. Well, now, that's the time that you ask, why? Di ba? So, one preventive measure is to really check on your expenses. Imong butangan jud og limit ang imong sweldo.
Budgetan
jud nimo na siya. Maski pag ikaw sole entrepreneur ka, sole proprietor ka, ikaw ang nagunod sa imong kwarta, ibalik jud sa negosyo. Ako, ingana ko, kaya ngano, pag sugod na kog fat cow, gipahulam ko sa akong ginikanan. Karon, nabalik man ako. Pagbalik na ako, after around 6 to 8 months, nabalik na ko itong fat cow na investment. So, I achieve return.
ROI na.
ROI ko. So, what do I do next? Alam ko naman, mag-happy-happy lang ko kay return na ako. At anong ginansya? Ako na ni, dili pwede nga na. Ang ako, ana, ako ang diskarte, ana, since nag-earn naman ang fat cow na daily basis, ako negosyo, punduhon ako itong kwarta. Di isa kong magkwagsweldo gani. Kuha lang kong sweldo pang ano, gasolina, pang kaon-kaon ginagmay. Kung nakay gusto paliton, palita lang good. Basta, kanang kabalo ka na murag, sakto pa si mong budget. Bro, I really get the chunk of the income to invest on another restaurant, which is karon,
Asian Cow.
So, kani karon, medyo ang cash dito na naaka, atong gibagsak na po sa laing negosyo. So, that's another risk, di ba? Kinansya na ka na nakay, let's say, butang ni mo nakay 1 million. Nami na kayo na sa Paminaw, but at the end of the day, 1 million. Pero nasa bangko. What is it doing? If there's an opportunity, you reinvest. But dili po siya pwede na kalang diretso-diretso lang. You have to study. You have to know what you're doing. You have to know what you want. Importante dyan na siya. Kaya nga, no, di mong kapwede kay tungod kusog ang tananan diha or kusog dito. Kung si concept, ana, ay nga ni, sandwich, abri po tayong ana.
Sundog-sundog.
Pag-abot sa pikas, kusog, ah, murag baligyan nila, oh, milk tea. Abri po tayo, ana. Di mong pwede nga na. Tapos dili ni mo forte. At the end of the day, maybe you will make it, but the less chances, kaya nga, no, you don't know what you want. You cannot work or you cannot do a business na ang gusto na sa laing tao. Dapat gusto ni mo. Murabag ka ng kurso. mas lami mo eskwela, di ba? Or mas lami mo tuon kung gusto nimo imong kurso. So that also relates to business. Di ka pwede magnegosyo na nimo gusto. No?
Laluma nimo mga kwan niya eh.
Lalum kong Bisaya, no?
Alright. Sige. Actually, ito, nakapangutan ako na kay lain-lain mong style. Some na ang ginabuhat sa uban ng mga negosyante is katulagay ito na negosyo. Kaya na kung ginakuha nila. Mm. And they wonder na nga nung nawala naman, nga nung asa naman pa doon ang kwarta. Diba? And that's, ma-feel na ni mo if there's a huge business change, no, sa business model nila, it's really more about the finances na napod na part. So if you're gonna know more about it, okay. Sige, so kanipod ba eh, when it comes to running a restaurant, since you have two already, it's not easy definitely. You need na kay staff, na kay mga quality assurance sa mong food, sa mong maintenance, sa mong equipment, and ana. How, unsa ba ang kailangan ni mo i-consider, let's say, kung naaman sa itong audience ang gusto magsugod o negosyo? Specifically about a
ako,
restaurant.
Ako, kung sulod mo sa negosyo na ka ng restaurant bar, maybe anything related to food ba?
Okay.
Importante experience. Yes, you could go to a culinary school. Ako, nag-culinary man ko. And I'm forever thankful na nisulod ko culinary school. Kinakatuon ko basics.
Okay.
But, murabag, in any other field ba? Tanan imo matunan sa eskwelahan, usually na nasa 40-50% try mo ma-apply sa imuhang negosyo or work, no? So number one jud experience. Paunsa magkuhang experience? Manarbaho ka. Narbaho jud ka. Trabaho kag kumpanyang dako or kung naakay ka lang idol kay ng mga tao, you work for them. Diba? There must be a reason ano idol nimo sila. Trabahoan nimo sila. Then, di ba? Learn as much as you want. That's what I always tell my staff, bakalabang mga bago na ko na staff. Pag manarbaho gani mo sa koa, kani this is, ano ha, this is like a routine na for me. This is what I always tell my people. Pag manarbaho mo sa koa, the moment you step in my restaurant or my workplace, don't, kumbaga, you have to be a sponge. Kalang ano ba? Si tawag as Bisaya? Sponge ba?
So may Bisaya sa sponge.
Catch bright.
Brand mo na.
Ah, brand din na. Sponge ba?
Kalang dali makasabot.
Oh, kalang pang sa panghugas ba? Ngano? Kalang sponge manggod. It can absorb and absorb and absorb a lot of water, di ba? You have to be like that po. Pag gusto ganit kag experience, sulod kag trabaho, don't be someone na ka lang ikaw ihaw or ikaw kabalo na ka. Kaya nga nun, narabaho pa ka, nga nun, nagtuon pa ka, nga nun, nagskwila pa ka, kung kabalo na ka tanan, no, dapat palakpakan na lang ka, ikaw na. Diba? Ano na lang, awarded na ka, bigyan ng jacket, diba? Pero dili man, gusto kang experience, you have to act like, absorb ka ba? You have to absorb as much as you can. Samot na kung imo ang dream kay gusto ka magnegosyo. Ako, for me, ako, I was raised in a family na negosyante. Okay. Diba? I walked the streets of Uyanggurin, Chinatown since I was 12, 10, early teens ba. And kami, ginatudluan dyan, may paunsa mag-ing-aning, paunsa mamaligya. And for me, before, it was like so dumb ba? Nung kalamurag makabugo man yun. Ano, kailangan man ako nitunan. But, karoon na ako na-realize ang importance sa experience. So, kato, pagtrabaho po na ako, nagtrabaho ko hotel, di po lalim. Murag ka lang na-feeling ba na murag kapuyan yung mas kasabaan, kapuy kay maingnan, kapuy kay masuguan. Diba? But, I always keep a mindset ba na sige lang kay ako maning ginabuhat karon maskin sakit kay para sa ako negosyo. Maskin wa pa good but you put a inspiration ba o put a dream ba. Pag sulod ni mo sa trabaho, perform kag tarong, you learn every day, progress ka pirme para sa imo sarili. Di ba? So number one, jud importante if you're opening a business, experience. And siguro kung number two, dapat kailangan you know what you do. para sa kung giingon ganiha, you know, you have to know what you want and you know what you're doing. Di man siya sayon o dili man na siya kalang overnight lang kabalo na ka unsay mong gusto, mubalik ka po na kung unsay mong ginabuild para sa imong sarili. O naaga nilain gani na karabang morning giplano pero ang baliktad ang naitabo. Pero dito man sila sa baliktad na ni succeed. So dili siya sipiat. Depende lang jud siya kung sa imong gusto.
Blessing in the
blessing in disguise. Ano yung mga ingana ba?
Okay. So kanipod pat, like since experience, tapos you also know what to do, the challenge mangod of some businesses, and I'm sure you know this, is that mauni ang gusto sa negosyante, pero ang mga empleyado sometimes dili makakonect sa kato na vision. Dili, it's not the same work ethic. Mm. Because ang negosyante, iyaha man, pero kung empleyado mo lang, eh, sometimes, okay lang sila.
Okay, ano lang, trabante lang ko, yun lang, di ba?
Ina na mindset. So, how do you manage or lead the team na inana? You know?
Ako, personally, unay man dugo sa negosyo. Hands-on man ko. Diba? I know some of the people here, I really know their full names. I really don't know how old are they, how many kids they have, unsa ilang nagihan in their life outside my restaurant, no? And that for me is a connection but a very important, you know, kay para kabalo ka pa unsa mo approach sila, ha? Ani man guna siya. Ang tao man gud lahi-lahi. Napoy laing-laing ways on how they learn. Napoy laing ways how they are willing to learn. Dapat kabalo ka kung unsay dagan sa utok si mga empleyado.
Okay.
Okay. Let's say mag-take ka og kanang ano ba, kurso or class na how to handle your employees, how to be a boss. Kana siya maybe for some dili applicable. Kay ngano, lahi-lahi man ang personality. Murabag ako willing ko mo tuon basta gusto na ako pag dili. So ako pong empleyado, sometimes na po yung ana na they're just there for working for a living, kuwal ang tagsweldo. So how do you manage that? Diba? For me, you really have to put your hands on it. Na kailangan dyan mo ikaw mismo mangunay na ingan niyo na siya, bay. Diba? And let them feel na at the end of the day, you're the boss. But to start with, you're also a teacher. Tunan mo. Inan mo. And sometimes gani, very ironic na sila pa yung mutudlo na ako. And I like that. Di ba? Kaya murag, ala no? Buang ano? Di pa dyan di ay ako na kabalo na ko tanan sa ako negosyo. Some, if you have good staff and you have good employees, some would just go approach you and say na, sir, murag mas ko ako guru yung nga ni sir kung
suggest
ba? And for some people, for some bosses, tanaw nila murag, insulto nila ako, murag kuyo kay ka. But for me, I always welcome suggestions. Muna, pagka na sa mga customer ba? Customer man na siya, mga friends, mga trade partners, or employees. Mingon dyan ko na kami, always may work in progress. Ako mismo na tag-iya, o kaning mga tao na ko dere na nag-work for me, they're always a work in progress. So nga, so unsay pasabot ana, mudawat may suggestion, mudawat may criticism, maskin sakit paminawon, dawata jud, no? And dapat dako jug heart ba, no? Di ka dapat ma-insulto, kira mo hilak, pero you have to know how to stand up ba, no? Kana mo jud na akong gina-relay permis sa kuwang tao na ako perfectionist man ko, pero di man taka expect ana pirmi, di ba? As human beings, you always make mistakes, and I also relay that to my employees ba na bahala na magkamali mo, pero kabalo ta how to correct it. And with that ano ba, with that type of environment I play around ba, mas tanaw na ko, murag mas align good sila sa kuha na we have one goal, and that is to serve people. We have to serve good food, tapos we have to let this business grow, no? Although dili siya kalang ingon mo one snap lang makasabot na ng tao, dili, it takes days, it takes weeks, it may take months in years for you to align with your people ba?
Yeah.
Diba? Some may go, some may stay. Eh, ang ako lang dyan, diha, matambag kay, you just have to treat them right and you know how to talk to them ba? How to, kumbaga, ikaw may kapitan. Kana, sila mo agad man ako sa direksyon ni mo. I-guide sila. Diba? Guide na to kay, panagsana, magbutay tendency na karabang tanaw na to ang atong tao or atong kasturya kay kabalo na gud siya sa atong ginapasabot. Tas mag-expect na dayon pag di mabuhat, ma-dismaya ta, makasukan pa nato. Pero with all honesty, katong tao na kasturya na to, wala siya kasabot. So I mean, that's ignorance, diba? But we cannot blame the individual. So what we do instead na masuko, tuduan na to, ingani ni siya. Pag mausap pa gani, di ata mga saba. Sigingnan na takay.
Nanakay
basis, sigingnan taka. So it's not me who has the problem. Kung di ikaw, kaya wala ka nag-comprehend. Or maybe tamad ka, or nakay problema, di ba? So kami, yeah, mo-apprehend yun me. Ako mo-handle ko og tao. Na-jud with an iron fist, jud. Sa mga tao na kaila sa kuha. If I need to shout at you, I will shout at you. If I need to curse you, I will definitely curse you. If I need to reprimand, I will reprimand. If I need to teach, I will teach. But at the end of the day, no hard feelings. No? Muna, number one pa na akong ginaingon sa mga bagong kalang apply good sa tua, dako kag heart. Kaya kung gamay kag heart, di ita kadawaton. Kaya nga no, siguro, makahilak tiyo ka dere. But what I can assure, if you ever you live here, you would be a better person, and you have more learnings that you could use maybe to venture on your own, no? Kumbaga, katuon sila. No?
Yeah. Hilak mo tanay. So, kanipun pat si, pag once na makasulod na sila, and here's the truth: when you are an employee, and then sometimes magod. Kung ikaw empleyado ka and then you have big dreams, you have this entrepreneurial tendencies, kanang gusto bitaw ka, muagi ka pagka-empleyado so that you will have experience para na kay idea when you have a business. And then, dili mo dyan na ito may iwasan ba yun na naman dyan empleyado na musulod sila because they just want to learn and then climb up the ladder, mahimo sila from this level rank and file, tapos mahimo sa managerial, then kalit lang, eventually they will resign.
Yeah.
And as a business owner, medyo
sakit
because nag-effort na ka, right? Pero what's your take on that? Is that a good thing or do you have bad feelings for the person or is it a good decision? What's your take on it in general? Like inana na mga situation.
Ani lang na siya. Para sa kalang mga sa itong mga viewers na maybe you're working now or you have plans to work. Kami mga employer, malipay man mo hawa mo. Maskin pagsakit sa mo, kay ngano, at least ang amo ang produkto or the people that we took care of for years, months, or whatever, nangita o growth. Ang sakit, ana, kana bang ni-resign gitungod lang kasab-an. That's so painful for us. That's gonna develop a bad feeling towards someone. Kay ngano man, karon na i-trend karon na kanabang gi-training kag 2 ka semana, 3 ka semana. After training, gi-employ ka. After 1 month, nakasab-an lang ka, wala na nagpakita, nag-awol na. Guilty mo. Guilty sila.
Hopefully dili.
Pero you know, let's call ano ba, kalang you have to have the proper work ethics ba no, regardless of maskin pag you're a homekeeper or you're a caregiver, you're a carpenter, you're a bank teller. Like, there's no taas baba pag when you say trabaho eh. You always have to maintain the work ethics ba? So muna, kung gusto gani umuhawa, if you already think that you are on the top and you have no more growth and you have no more reason to stay in this company, nanghin mo. Diba? Nanghin mo na, sir, we need, or I want to grow personally. Oh, honest to God, pati ako malipay. Na murag, someday, mahimot ng kompetensya. Someday, mahimot ng partners. Never know. Or someday, you would come to me and offer me products that I could use. And that's so fulfilling. Na murag, di ba, uy, taon ako ni dati. Tapos karoon, negosyante. Murag, kana mo'y lami na feeling. And maybe in a million years, I would never have grudge. Or I would never have, kumbaga, bad feelings about someone na nihawa. Because you cannot limit people to grow eh. Like going back, when they enter into my place, ingon na to sa ilaha, you be a sponge. At some point, ang sponge, mapuno man, o wa na ika-absorb. Meaning, you're good to go. Diba? You're good to go. So, kung maabot ang imong tao, or imong empleyado, or your manager, or your chef, or your server, sa ingana na point that they feel like they cannot grow anymore, then you have to respect. Ayaw ka suko. Even though if it's sakit because you invested money, you invested skills, effort, and learnings to that person, ayaw jud ka suko. Kaya nga no, kung kwintahon ni mo, ang kanang tao na nihawa sa imo has served you well. Yeah. That's why it's so painful for us employers na muhawa. Kaya nga no, ginaservisyo ang tagtarong o nagsaligan na to. So dapat dili ta masuko. No, dili ta masuko. We have to be proud. Malay mo, ang iyang next endeavor sa iyang life, mahimo siya ka lang something na you would be really proud of.
So, kabalo ka na nangigikan sila sa iyo.
At least you could say na murag, kani, believe kayo ni tawhanan ni kay kika na sa kuha. O, ako'y nagtudlo dyan, ana. Pero grabe ko ka-proud. So, wala dyan tayo grudge, diba? So, I would never develop bad feelings to people who go, diba?
Yeah. I mean, it you know, you sometimes nag-buta na kagwarta, nag-invest ka sila, salary, trainings, morale efforts, your time also in educating them, and sometimes they leave. It's painful,
painful.
Normal.
Sakit
pero, you know, pero, at the end of the day, it's also good news
Reality, eh. That's reality.
You diba? Can't stop them
you from can't stop them from growing. As much as kita, as, let's say, business owners like us, gusto ta mo grow sa tong business, gusto ta mo grow as a person, we have to leave some things down. Di man ta pwede lang nakargaho na tulatan na to the top. Diba? Like our job from day one and day 100 would be different. There are some jobs you have to leave here in order to grow here. That also applies to our people, diba? To our employees na nagatrabaho para na to.
Okay. Actually, guys, naghanakitag na na-cover, no? So, we're going to have one last question I'm going to ask Patrick one. And then, huna-huna po kag question of the day for them to for them to answer sa comment section.
Comment section.
So, imuhana na siyang flow. Okay. So, last question by Kanisha is, in terms of, like, having a business, maski na ikaw magod ang tag-iya, kabalong magod ta na, naaputay limitations, right? You may be good, so for example, you're good in cooking, you know how, like, operations, but maybe there are some areas that you need help on. Diba? So, ako, naana, mapugun, nakakitantanan natin yun, naana. The question is, how do you, ikaw personally, how do you manage that? Like, kung what are your strengths, but you also have your weaknesses, but the weaknesses still should be like, ano, kumbaga, nagapoy focus diha, ginaunsa ni mo pagkuana ng weakness na na dapat maatiman gyapon ni pero at the same time mabuhat na po na kung kailangan buhaton diri.
Kana siya that's common for business owners or I mean not only business for individuals ba kay di man jud maato tanan, di ba? Like ako personally sa ako ang trabaho. Di mo ko how to bake. Di ka how to cook, bake,
okay.
I can make a good slice of cake or maybe a cookie. But up to that extent lang. Pero paluto ako, mas comfy ko.
So, ano yung strength?
Sa restaurant, di man pwede walay dessert. Diba? Di pwede walay sweets. So, how did I manage that flow? Flow man na siya, for me. It's something negative because that's something that you don't know how to do. So, kung samanin mo na siya buhaton, para na ako, I have to study more.
Okay.
And I have to learn from other people.
Okay.
Okay. But ang catch niya is you are already doing something. Di ka gusto out of focus. At the same time, you could manage your flow. One thing I learned is you have to hire the right people. You have to hire people that ang ilahang, ang imuhang flow kay hilig nila. Ug ang imuhang flow ilahang strength. They would help you fix your flaw, do better, teach you how to do better on things that you are not good at. And diba, that's so ironic. Why would I hire someone to teach me when I'm in fact the business owner? Ayaw dyan na gamitan na mentality. Ayaw dyan na gamitan na mentality. If di ka kabalo, pagtuon, kung di dyan mo kaya, you get someone to teach you. Maybe you don't need to hire, maybe you can get a friend or na kay mga amigo or your family na mas haud sa ingaran na butang. Like ako, di ko haud mag-bake. Pala, banjo ko mga more learnings. Facebook, internet, libro. Babadan dyan ako na akong sarili. Hantod sa makaingon ko na murag kabalo na ako. But on a business end, di naman ako na ako na kaya mabuhat tungod kay sa kadaghan-daghan ng kabuhaton responsibilities, I cannot do everything. So, going back, you have to hire the right people. You have to hire right people to do your business and grow your business. Because you cannot grow it alone. Kisa ba na nang ingon na na eh? Jack Ma man na? Jack Ma. Ito yung chick ba?
Murag ikaw.
Oh, murag kita. You have to grow your people and you have to teach your people well. They may go, but they will always be the frontliners of your business. Diba? Di makaka-operate yung restaurant, ikaw lang isa, naga na yung mga pangutana sa kuha, naka lang, Kuya, oh, ikaw, Jay Cusinero? Ako, oo, oh, nga naman. Siko, regalo to. Anako, di po siguro. O di mo, posible. Like, kag 50 kataw, ikaw isang magluto, unsa ka, Superman? Di ba, di dyan na sa may tabo. So, you have to find the right people. Okay? So, kung nakay ka lang mga weaknesses ba, ayaw ka discourage. Dapat, gamito ni mo na yung weakness to grow. Number one, you have to admit na hinay dyan ka diha. Kaya if you be denial, kumbaga muingon ka ng kabalo na good ka, na hinay ka, pero muingon ka na, dili, ay, kusog ko just to show off, makita man gyapon as a product. Never be afraid to, kumbaga, never be afraid to tell yourself that you need help. Never be afraid to tell yourself na kailangan ni mo mutuon pa. Kaya at the end of the day, maskin pag unsa nakakahal, maskin unsa kakasuccessful, there are some things that you are actually gonna learn more in the future. Baka kabalo, baka karon, makatuon kay ngani, ugma ingani. And that for me is the kumbaga pinakagwapo na character you need to show ba. No? Kay sama na ako, di man ko naingon na perfect ko, ako negosyo, guwapo, but happy ko. No? And at first, ako, personality na ko, kaladyo kong tipong nakalang pag-ingnan ko na way lami. Ah, musoko, dyo ko. Kulang na lang itsa ng plato. Ako nang itsa ba? Pero, what I learned was, pag matuon ni mo or pag maingnan ni mo sarili and you admit na you're at fault or you're weak and you need help, from that time pa lang na maingon ni mo na you're actually growing. Kaya nga no, di ba? Pag open gani ka for information or open ka for learnings, you would actually learn them. Di ba? Kumbaga kita, kung na ay mangutana sa tua, willing tatabangon. Kaya nga no, willing man sila magtuon. Inga na po ta dapat. So kumbaga, what goes around comes around ba? Na always keep an open mind jud ba, no? Maskin paghinay and feel ni mo down kay ka kadi ka kabalo mangingani nga na, then na may reason nga na may siguro way na how to get up, di ba?
Yeah.
Muna, di ba ako always na ko ginaingon ba sa like my family, amigo, empleyado na bahala na you would take 10 days to learn something. Diba? Bahala na you would take 10 days na sige lang kag higda di sa lugba na di akabalon sa pagbangon. Kaya basta one day ikaw raga po yung mismo sarili ni mo mag-pick up sa mo sarili ba? Ikaw raga mismo mag-ingon sa mo sarili na ah, kani kaya na nato ni buhato ni ganila. No? You don't ayaw, dili pwede na permanent lang ka gina-down mo yung sarili. na di na ko ni mabuhat, di na ko ni mabuhat, di na ko ni mabuhat, kaya di mo na mabuhat. Diba? You have to, one day you have to say na kaya na ko ni buhaton. Optimistic ba? Diba? Para po, ang imong ma-embody po na baga character ba na? Hindi siya kamutuon. Diba? Ano, good.
Imuhang batasan.
Batasan, mabatasan. Oh.
Okay.
Woo! Tas-tas to ba? Pila ka minutes na ta?
Pila ta ka minutes? 1 hour! Huh? 1 hour na to? Sige.
Tama na,
bro. So let's wrap up. So guys, naabot na rin tag 1 hour. Wala may kabantay. No, sorry kayo. Medyo taas siya. But hopefully, definite, and for me, naghan ko nakuha ng value from Patrick coming from a practitioner. That's what we're trying to do here as well. Na we're gonna gather different practitioners, ilang specific business, ilang field, para makashare po sa experience. Na dili na po, gikan na po sa mo. Ano, kay lahi mamig mga experience. And so, in order for us to appreciate Patrick also, drop your comment section sa comment section about sa iyang pangutana.
Kung na sila yung mga pangutana, pwede po sila mangutana dito. Tas ako yung mutubag. Ako yung mutubag.
Siya na yung mutubag.
So kung na mo yung mga karabang mga pangutana na how to start up a business, unsay mga guwapong negosyo, di man ako maingon kung sa guwapong negosyo, but I could actually try to help o suggest na how you would realize kung sa'y gwapo na negosyo para sa mo sarili. Diba? So, see you in the comment section.
Ano sa mga mong pangutana sa ila, hapat? Like, kanang para they can start engaging with us.
Ang gwapo siguro na pangutana ba, no? Kay since tanan ba kay mo, ingon man sila, yahay ang negosyante. Diba?
Kung alam mo lang.
Oh, karon ang akong pangutana sa inyo, ha? Unsa sa tanaw ninyo ang negosyo na hayahay para sa ilaha?
Okay.
Di ba?
So para sa inyo ha, murag unsa ay negosyo na hayahay
para sa inyo ha. Okay. Okay. Kay murag, di ba? Gwapo na ingana na pangutana kay para at least kabalupod mi ba on our end pag kami mo tanaw sa lain negosyo makaingo gumiglisod. Tanaw ako gusto na ko mabalan ko sa atong viewers unsa ang hayahay para sa ilaha. And I'm hoping you're gonna drop a lot of questions in your comment box sa to ang video o paningkamutan na to na tubago na to na tanan, no?
Alright.
Okay.
Thank you. So, thank you guys for joining us. This is Patrick. He has two restaurants, Fatkaw Asian Cow, located in Davao City. Ang Fatkaw is located sa Vimapa. Tapos, ang Asian Cow is sa may...
Mabini.
Mabini. No, so, doon lang kayo sila and their food is really great. Ako, hinahalki ko silang food. So, find time to dine sa yung mga restaurants as well. So, Pat, thank you so much for being in our show.
Pag magbisita po sila sa itong restaurant, pwede ko nila pangitaon o mangutana sila kung sa suggestion sa ilang kaunon, ako pa yung sumuluto para nila. Okay?
Power.
So, guys.
Thank you and see you on the next video.
See you.